Okay. What is grace? Anybody can tell?
That's something that has come from above.
What is grace?
Not good. Right time.
There's another expression for grace is called that.
No, grace is not that. Grace is not that. Grace is krapa. Okay. What is it?
Fruits of dharma.
Grace is called anugraha. Okay. I will give you a formula to get enough infinite grace every day. You want to take it?
Yes.
Let me master for you. Let me very, very costly. You want to take a formula which will give you infinite grace every day?
No.
Huh?
Yes.
You don't want? You want
yes,
it?
Yes, you want.
So, the formula for grace is called gratitude. The moment you are grateful, you have gratitude for the existence, the grace will start flowing.
Gratitude
every minute of your life, if you are grateful to existence, which is God, the grace will start flowing in abundance. I'll tell you what grace is, okay? Next step. But first is, the formula for grace is called gratitude. Okay? A small child understood it very well. I'll put a video of that. Pratibha, you can show. Who is that? Vinith, come and talk about grace. Okay? The small child understood so well for the grace, meaning of grace, he'll just talk about it. Okay?
This is not a small child, this is a divine child.
So actually in my school I had an assembly, I had to speak there about gratitude. So
let me loud.
I started it.
Center.
So gratitude in short is being grateful for whatever you have, and it's a great attitude. Gratitude, great attitude. So you have to be, the more you're grateful, the more blessed you will be. Like it's, people say what you give is what you get. The same is here. If you give your gratitude, you will get the gratitude from maybe not the same person, but from the universe. And so there was a story of a man, he was completely broke. So this is a true story. So he was completely broke, he didn't even have a home. He would live in an abandoned apartment. And every day, so his roommates were very rash, as you know, like they were almost thugs because they were also in their abandoned bad financial condition. So every day when he woke up, he was grateful to God for giving him another day of amazing life. Because who knows, one day while sleeping, somebody can come and assassinate him. So every day he was grateful, every single day. So one day he met this amazing man at a seminar. This man changed his life. So this person who I'm talking about, his name is Mark Anastasi, and now he has written one of the world's most famous business books, The Laptop Millionaire, and now he's a millionaire. So this shows a person who is completely broke, he was grateful and the universe gave him the gratitude back to him, and he's now a millionaire. Yeah.
See, you have to understand grace, okay? For understanding grace, you have to understand how you take food, eat food. When you eat food, okay, we have to do prayer before eating food. Do you know why you have to do prayer before eating food?
So that the effort has been
given. So the God has given you that dates, food. Okay? It's more than that. Aham Vaishwanaro Bhutva Taninam Deyamashitam Pranapana Samayukto Pachamyannam Chaturvidam. You bought the food for that day. You thought you went and purchased from the market. The universe gave you the food. One apple has to come from the tree has to come from sunlight, sun has to come from the universe. Every action is coming from the universe to you. The food you eat is also digested by the God in the form of the heat, fire inside, Vaishwana Agni. Okay? Now you tell me what you did. complain the food is not good. Is it gratitude? Is that right attitude? That's why you pray before food. You say Brahmarpanam, Brahmahavihi, Brahmagnau, Brahmanahutam, Brahmaiva, Tena Gantavyam, Brahmakarma Samadhina. The food I have received has come from Brahman, the universe. The apple has come from apple tree has come from earth, earth has come from sun, sun has come from the universe. Without the universe action, not a single thing moves, not a blade of grass moves. I received it. I ate it. The food got digested, not because of me. It got digested for the divine energy. Okay? So more and more than that, you want to eat the food, you lift your hand and put it to your mouth. So how does the mouth know the hand, the moment hand comes, your mouth has to open? How does the mouth know hand has to open? Then some chemicals are produced in the body. All of them are happening without you knowing. And everything is divine mother. Yadevi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Matru Rupena Samsthita, Namastase, Namastase, Namo Namaha. Ya Devi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Smriti Rupena Samsthita, Namastase, Namastase, Namo Namaha. Ya Devi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Lajja Rupena Samsthita, Namastase, Namastase, Namo Namaha. Ya Devi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Shuddha Rupena Samsthita, Namastase, Namastase, Namo Namaha. Your hunger is not your hunger. The Divine Mother is manifesting in you as hunger.
Created.
Not created, she is the hunger. Ya Devi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Shuddha Rupena Samsthita. But you remember something. You never remember something. The Divine Mother operates as memory, smriti. Okay? Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu, Matru Rupena Samsthita, Thai, mother. That love in you is not your love. Boy lives, I love you, you love me, is none of your love. It's universal mother's love. Okay? So, it is happening through you. You are the instrument. Without that doesn't happen, but it's not happening because of you.
So my life is being lived, I'm not living my life.
The divine is living through you. Divine is not separate from you. Divine is you. You have become a human child forgetting the divine child. That's all. Is it clear? Now I'll tell you what is grace. The grace means, the moment you say, I am individual, you forget the totality, what's happening, then you are living for yourself. That means you are separate from the universe. Conceptually, not really a separation. So you say, I am independent, I am separate. You know, say, you take care. So then you do a lot of struggle in life. Because you are responsible for yourself. See, for example, your own child. So mother says, beta, tomorrow homework has to be done. Shall I help you? No, mommy, I will do it. So he is struggling. Mommy says, do it. So now the child says, mommy, help me. So the moment you understand the divine mother's role in your life, the divine Brahman's role, consciousness role in your life, the entire consciousness starts operating through you, for the universe. So it is like this. The hand goes to the mouth, mouth opens, saliva comes, the chemicals are produced, everything is taken care, not by you, by the universal mother. So similarly, some action has to happen. Right now you are struggling with action because you are responsible. You say, divine mother, don't come into picture. So the moment you understand the role of the divine mother will provide so many things to you without you asking, so that your role is performed better than what you can do individually. That's called grace. So grace is getting the right thing at the right point of time, for the role you are responsible for, not for your selfishness. Have you understood the grace? So your concept of grace is oh my God, I have not studied for the exam tomorrow. Can you come and give me some grace so that, so at least I can get grace mark? That is not grace. Grace is you are doing service to the, you are doing everything as a service to the God. You understand God is operating through you. Then everything is required to perform your role better, get through your karma, learning happens automatically. Any doubts about grace? So you know the formula for grace? Gratitude. Be grateful to the divine for every moment of your life. So do you have a body, mind, intellect, eyes, everything is operating. Have family, society, everything is in a good order. So that it's not for you to do service to the divine. You are breathing. There's no guarantee that next breath will come. So be grateful to that breath. Be grateful to the existence for the one bowl of food which you are getting. So please be true to yourself. Are you living in gratefulness or complaining all the time?
Complaining
all the time. Why? Why are you doing that?
Because all these days we never came to you. No.
Coming to you, coming to here was a part of the grace. Okay? So is grace clear at all? Now the grace has something different from the gravity. That's why I put a Newton's apple falling on the head of the Newton. Okay? So apple falling on the head of Newton. So Newton was sitting one day and apple fell on his head and it struck him. That's a gravity. Even before there was a gravity. After that also there's a gravity. But it struck him that there's a gravity. So imagine there was a grace actually. If you're sitting below the coconut tree. It was grace that apple fell on his head and discovered gravity. Because of the grace, you could get an aeroplane and all. That's a different thing. Okay? Why it got gravity here? Grace is totally opposite of gravity. Gravity is the law of the earth. Okay? Grace is the law of the God, divine. Grace pulls you up, gravity pulls you down. Karma pulls you down, dharma uplifts you. Gratitude uplifts you, complaining takes you down. Okay? Gravity means the law of the earth, which is karma. Grace means even if you have fallen, lifted. Any situation, you will be lifted. That provided you to understand the role of grace, role of Divine Mother, role of consciousness in your life, then you will gradually more and more to sink in the universal. Have you read any book of Coelho? Alchemy?
Yes.
The whole universe cooperates. The whole universe cooperates one who has a clear intention. So your intentions are clear, your intentions are dharma, your intentions are service, your intentions are in tune with the dharma. The entire universe will cooperate with you. Not one individual. Now your husband's cooperation also is difficult. That's called grace, okay? I'll just give you an example of life of Mata Amritandani. She was a child, used to sing and dance Krishna's name, and they were here from a fisherman family, fisherman community. They didn't feel comfortable, so girl child singing and dancing. Okay, who will marry this girl? What will people think that some disease is there in our house? They threw that girl out of the house. Okay? Imagine a girl child of 8 or 9 years being thrown on the street, on the seashore. She kept on singing, chanting divine name. And when she starts to sleep, one dog used to come and become her pillow. When she is hungry, one eagle used to bring fish and drop into her mouth. When she is thirsty, one cow used to come and drop milk in her mouth. So much of trust on existence. Do you have the trust in the existence? Or you have a complaint in the existence? Leave every minute in the gratitude, trust that existence, every single thing of your life will be clear. What has happened to you today? The pain or suffering is because what attitude, what thinking you have done today, yesterday. Accept responsible for that. Karma is taking acceptance responsibility. Karma is not, what is it, something bad. Karma means I am responsible for what is happening to me. Why I am responsible? Because I said I will take care. You said you will take care. Good and bad, take care. The moment you offer that to God, everything divine will take care of you. You will do your role according to dharma. And no karma will touch you. And grace will flow in your life. It will overflow and fill the whole universe. Any questions?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
When you're talking about karma and grace, what if I say I have the grace of God? That does it lead to karma?
Who is I?
Me, as a body existence.
Is that me? Is that you?
No, but the world is speaking if I
is
say.
Is that you?
No.
So you have to say, this is an instrument of God, not your me.
Okay, what if I say, what if that instrument says that I have the grace of God?
If the instrument doesn't have to have the variable grace, the grace will flow. A screwdriver doesn't have to say, they should not need to pray to the electrical engineer. Oh, electrical engineer, I pray to you, use me properly and open the screw. Just say, I am at your disposal. Whatever has to happen to you will happen. Yes.
So we hear such splendid melodies and all that.
Right.
Now that particular musician might not have said that I am an instrument of the divine. Some people say that, many people don't say that. But we still hear the great melodies and all that.
Right.
So even without me thinking that I am an instrument of the divine, and I keep on spending time on some instrument, keep on playing, I will still hear it.
Arre Baba, what you are saying is, there is a divine is there in the child also, that person also, whether he knows it or not.
Correct.
And why is he playing that? Is he doing it or it's happening? The divine is... whether he knows it or not, it's happening, no? So what is the problem? Only his understanding makes his changes in life. Right? We'll break a cup of coffee.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
We'll break for tea now. Tea served.